I'm back. While I'm in the swing of it, we're gonna, you know, keep swinging. Take a quick sip. Why didn't you take a sip in between episodes? Because my brain doesn't work like that, friend. Doubles the effects of mystery potions, and then actually unlocked another chest for me, which gave me a bomb back. So that was free. Free real estate. Let's try to keep our combo up here at the start, get through these early floors. It definitely has a learning curve to this game. It's really fun though. I like the aesthetic. I like the gameplay. You know what? I said I was gonna watch the video and work on the FPS problems, but I did not actually do that. Hold on. I'm looking at my OBS recording instead of like the actual screen. So my shooting was a little off there. I'm like checking the frame rates on it to make sure it's doing okay. So we can definitely bomb into that chest. I think it's worth it. My general consensus with that chests are pretty good. Well, I mean, that's a pretty good quest to get too. I think that quest could be very helpful. Maybe I need to melee more. I didn't melee that much. I'll give you cash, but you can't roll until the next boss fight. I've become better at rolling, but I actually think I can get away with this. I'll take the cash. I gotta think about like what I really want to use my cash for. Though I need to like weigh my advantages and disadvantages a little bit more. I think this game has a little bit more strategy to it than I'm willing to admit right now. I'm still new to the game. I definitely would like to play more of it. This game is extremely fun. I like the combo system. I think like the fast pace of it is a good, like, refreshing take on a game like this, because generally I find that roguelike games tend to at least recently be pretty slow. Not that that's a bad thing, but like you've had a lot of deck builders coming out in recent. I can't roll, so I gotta shoot these open. Restore +4 stamina when KOing an enemy. Alright, coffee beans. I gotta grind some coffee. But I found that a lot of roguelikes recently have been slower. Like, they've that's not a bad thing. I don't wanna take this a bad way, because I'm a huge fan of the genre in general. I love roguelikes. What I have a problem with is when it feels like a roguelike game is extending things for no reason. Some fights in certain games just feel like they take really long, and it's a bad feeling. Purchasing increases price by 15. I mean, it's pretty cheap, so we'll do that for now. Because it's only 5 for a bomb, and we can do this. This will give us a couple of chests here. Oh, we got a bomb back. Double the potion mystery effects, please. Minus move speed. That's just great. That's great. That's great. Why would I want it any other way? We can definitely bomb into here. That's fine. Half an apple doesn't bother me. But this style of gameplay is way up my alley. Like, I love Nuclear Throne. Probably one of my favorite roguelites personally. I think Nuclear Throne may very well be my personal favorite roguelite. I'm gonna take this mystery. You can't just give me a mystery and not expect me to solve it. I'm Sherlock Holmes. Oh, he exploded. What the heck are you? No rolling. I can't roll. All right, deal with him. He's dead, but the bullet is still in the air. All right, that was interesting. It's Fox Lion. How are you today, my friend? That's not good. We're gonna wait on this. Ah, I think I rolled into him. I need to get the heck out of here. I don't even know what I just picked up. I'm trying to get away from Fox Lion. All right, Fox Lion, but angry. How are you? You can increase your bat speed all you want, but it won't stop me from just shooting you, really. That was all I did. So he gives you the sword. Yeah. What do we got here? Choices. Permanent damage. Oh, permanent damage. Oh, dude, that sounds like a good quest. 25% to current weapon type. We're gonna just go with it. Why are there two exits, by the way? I'm gonna take this exit. I like this exit. So that's our red bullets now. We've hit red tiers. Nah. And let me explain this a little bit too. Back on that topic of like roguelikes taking a longer time in general, it could just be my gameplay style, but even like certain games still felt like they took a while. So like Enter the Gungeon's Floor generation, it took a while. I'm not saying that this game won't take a while. I haven't finished a run. I don't know what the normal duration of a run is for this game, but in general, 25% accuracy to the current weapon type. When you can throw a bomb, shoot plus one, bonus one. Can only carry two bombs at a time. So it's like having four bombs. I think I would lose bombs by doing that. So we're actually gonna pass. Oh, hello, 50% to treasure. Don't mind if I do. So Enter the Gungeon. I mean, like, runs can take a while to Enter the Gungeon. It's a fun game, and you could definitely play it a lot faster. You can speed up your run times to Enter the Gungeon once you get better at, like, dodging in rooms. What am I trading again? Three bombs. Okay. Release to return boomerang and do a timed hit. Wait. Hold on. I need, like, an empty space, please. Okay. What? I think if you just release it, it does a hit. Is what I'm assuming that is? Because it looks like there's a slash at it, at the end of it. Now, I might have to use the boomerang, but we'll see. Right now, the dragons are doing a good job of taking care of the webs for me. As long as that's the case, we will avoid using our boomerang. The dragons are my friends. Dragons are friends, not food. Thank you, dragons. But also, no thank you for that combo ruiner. Combo breaker, as they say in the business. So that's my heart trader. I could trade hearts to it. I mean, come on. I gotta get revenge on these things. The potion of mystery reduced my movement speed. Minus money! Dude, these potions, they have not been very kind to me. I feel insulted. Yeah, I'll do a little bit. What are you doing to me? Thank you. More money, I guess. All right, let's go. I know there's a chest over there. I definitely saw like a little piece of land. But a lot of roguelikes too have been card games or like strategy games. And I don't think, you know, every game has its own version of strategy. I mean, in this game, you know, you want to play more aggressive, get your combo up. You want to play more like passive and be, you know, passive. But why aren't you using the freaking boomerang? You're just using your freaking starting gun. Well, I did take like 25% damage from my starting gun, so I'm kind of obliged to just use it. All right, don't insult the starting gun. Once you insult the starting gun, that's when the starting gun becomes the best weapon of all time. Please burn down the house, dragon. I need you to. Thank you. You definitely get a bigger bonus there for having a combo, but it's kind of hard to keep your combo up sometimes, at least on this floor with all the freaking spiders. So I do see the potion. The potions have not been kind to me, but I still believe in the potions. Give him a heart. A heart. I don't know why I said it like that. We're going to throw two bombs here because I know that this... Wow, it's a jackpot. 10 seconds of attack speed. Apple. No... I know the apple's healing, but at the same time, I'm not that interested. The money is weird, because sometimes it has uses, and other times I don't feel like it does. But overall, that was really good. Let's see... Okay, we can't get in there, because I bombed from a stupid angle. Even though I knew the depth of the bomb explosion, that was my bad. It's alright. Skeleton shoots plus one bomb. What the heck is a skeleton? I've never seen a skeleton, so I'm not scared. You're trapped. You think the skeletons are the portals? Or is it an enemy I haven't seen yet? It's gotta be like an enemy I haven't seen yet, right? You telling me I didn't dodge that bullet? I swear I rolled through it. What's with Shadow the Hedgehog over there, by the way? I know I took a lot of bad damage. So next floor, we're gonna have this ghost start spawning too, which isn't gonna be pleasant. Ah, that's gonna be our full heal. I guess I need it because I'm bad at this game. What? Times 100 self knockback? Your body damages enemies while knockbacked. Ah. Plus 2 bombs on level up. Happy explosion day. I mean, we're gonna get destroyed by the boss and kill him with our ricochet. That's the goal. Alright, heal me. So we can definitely get in there for one bomb. We could get in there. Let's do that. Plus 1 sword damage. Alright, it's a red sword. Slash away, my friend. I gotta remember the sword. I think the sword reflects bullets. It's good. It's good. The spooky ghost is coming. Okay, so it glitched because my screen was trapped, and it was talking about the spooky ghost. That was funny. It didn't know what to do, so I couldn't move. Alright, so we got rid of that snail. Plus 10% bullet damage. 1.2 times combo for a 1 combo. That's a 2 combo. There's our spooky ghost. So where's the rest of the enemies, please? Oh, he's down here. Hello, alligator. Or are you a crocodile? The reality is that we may never know. I don't have a bomb to access that, and the guy has no bombs in his shop. I actually can't buy anything in his shop. Sadly. I don't have the money. The closest thing is this. Restore health after KOing enemy with a bomb. I don't really use bombs offensively like that, so it wouldn't even be that useful. Because this run, we don't have an excess of bombs. But I'll look around for some chests. I think we got everything. Okay. So then let's move it, or lose it. Or both. The air grows cold. Hello, spook. That's pretty good. Only a 1 combo, though? I thought you get a combo for each enemy you kill. Ooh, baby. We're in there. 2.6 combo. Ooh. Hold on. We're getting times 3.2 on our quest. That's insane. Oh, it's over. Dang. Did I finish the quest? I wanted to get the extra damage before I fought the boss. There we go. Okay, so we roll down to that one. Just keep to yourself. And keep hitting him. That's the goal. What a freaking... He's playing air hockey with my body. Insane. What a sad way to get hit, to be honest. What is that attack? Excuse me? What the heck was that? I'm out of here. The thing. What are you doing, sir? I'm still shooting. Dude, I don't trust it. Am I supposed to walk into that? Is there, like, anything I can pick up before I go down there? I'm scared. There's no healing. And I have no bombs. Oh, jeez. He grabbed me. So now it's the same boss fight in an arena. It goes back in. Insane. I was out of dash juice there. That's okay. Oh, he got me. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. No. This was my moment. I was so focused. No. Why is this boss so difficult? I'm disappointed in myself. Mm-mm. Don't you dare teach me how to use bombs. Don't you patronize me like that. The game's just trying to be nice to you. I don't buy it. Why am I so bad at that boss fight? I'm trying to think so hard. Like, what am I incapable of doing that I'm so bad at dodging the attacks? Well, who the heck are you? Well, I guess we have to take it. Because it's my only option. I mean, I don't have to take it. Chat, hey dude, I can tell by your skills you're really good. For such a cool dude like yourself, I can get you a real run. None of this easy stuff. What you say? We're not talking, Chad. I'll stay the virgin. That's okay. Oh, baby! It let us in here. And we got plus one bomb for it. So I guess you're more incentivized to use bombs with the jalapeno pepper. Because you can only carry two. 450 gems for one floor, ? Which means it's probably gonna fight that weird giant thing. What? What are you doing here? Can you be a first floor boss? Or is this the for one floor effect? I'm not too sure. It could have been a result of the curse I took. It's only for one floor, so even if this, you know, if it's stuck around like permanently, then I'd be worried. But if it's not permanent, I'm not worried. I did take a hit. I feel like I walked into a fire on a bush, but, you know, correct me if I'm wrong. That's just my assumption. Alright, gems for that is a pretty good trade because we just got 450 gems, so that's actually not a bad trade. Apple drops, plus. This is also a pretty good trade here because we can get in there with our double bomb to the face. Plus magnetism, permanent stamina. My only quest right now, so it's not bad to take. No bad choice. This is a freebie. What? Did I take damage from that? I saw my health pulse at the top of my screen. So I may have very well taken damage, but I wasn't paying much attention. Why do you take all the curses, man? I don't know. It doesn't seem that much of a problem. A golden heart. Now that I've eaten the golden apple, there is nothing can stop me. Confidence is key. As long as you have something to make you believe you can be confident, you can be confident. And I believe this golden apple is what allows me to have the confidence of the gods. Oh, baby. You seeing this? There's only one bat left? Perfect that floor. Perfect that floor. I don't know if you heard that clap, but your camera is mine. I want it back, please. You think I can beat this boss without taking damage? I'm gonna challenge myself to do that. Alright, sir. Just keep shooting. What is that attack? Oh, it comes back down. I definitely didn't beat him without taking damage, that's for sure. Also just got hit again. He tries to pseudo-predict you from what I've seen from that. This guy... Oh, his bullets bounce, so the green fire bounces. Okay. Good to know. Okay, this is just... It's raining. Pretty heavy rain there, my man. I didn't win, but I'm not proud of the win. Let's put it that way. 20% attack speed's pretty freaking good. Permanent health. Oh, dude. I need to take that. I'm a baddie. Permanent health is too good, right? But I also need to heal. Accept the gift. Give me that gift. I have one bomb. We did have our level up here. On level up, get half of that. Doubles current weapon's max ammo. I don't have a current weapon. So if we use that, could help us out more. Is there anything I can reach with one bomb? It looks like only one chest. That's kind of bad. That was an apple, so we definitely did heal a little bit. I think I'm gonna take the permanent health. I'm gonna be honest with you. I think this is the play here. You take the quest. Hope you can heal enough off of that to get you back in a good spot, and if you can build up a nice base of HP, then, you know, now we're talking. I know this means I'm not gonna have a weapon, so this floor is gonna be tough. Because normally, to get through, I've relied on lucky dragons placements or having a weapon that can hit through the spiders. Like, the first time I ever played, I had the fireball on my sword. But the spiders are nasty, dude. They don't show up on the first floor here, so, you know, we might as well get ahead while we still can. I definitely should be playing more aggressive here, getting my combo up, because that'll help me get my max HP bonus faster. Okay, so all the bullets die when you clear the floor. That's good. So Telly, it's kind of like a mixed bag. He can be good, can be bad. The healing there is helpful. Double the effect of mystery potion. Yeah, I mean, you gotta take bullets pierce through enemies, I think. I think bullets that pierce are just too good to pass up. So let's see what we get from Telly. Something good, but the next boss will be hard. Birds, 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 birds. I didn't realize the birds was a weapon. Birds of prey. I know that there's a chest here, but I didn't know how much the chest was gonna be applicable. Boxes have more giant gems. I mean, like, I just got two pretty good gems, right? I mean, I don't know how good they were, but I'd say they're pretty good. So we have a gun now. Which makes up for my previous incompetence, to say the least. All right, dragon. Give it to him good. Get rid of the webs. Through the fire and the flames, these webs carry on. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. What? Are you messing with me? What did I get hit by? Was it one bush that was on fire that I didn't pay attention to? That's gotta be it. These dragons don't have their reticle centered. They fire like a little bit off point from where their head is. Oh, come on, dude. Can you come over here, spider? Yes, yes, yes. That dragon won't leave me alone, so I gotta take it one step at a time, okay? Penguin for the heal. I mean, I guess we gotta take it, right? I really don't have any complaints about that. It is what it is. I'm like half a heart, so... Or not half a heart, I'm a quarter of a heart. So that'll be it. Once per run, that's all I will ever see from you. You don't know me anymore, Penguin. We're not friends. Alright, so let's try to be a little bit more aggressive now that we have the HP too. Hopefully we can use this chance to build up our combo and then get hit by the buzzsaw and ruin our combo immediately. I wouldn't have it any other way. Also did it again there. These freaking spider webs are insanely busted. By the way, they eat all of your bullets. What's up with that? How's our HP looking? Not good, because I did just take some random hits. I got hit by the buzzsaw, and I don't really have any bombs, so I actually think we're good on this floor. Let's just give it a go. I'm not going to play that machine, because I don't have the excess hearts to be dumping in it. Saw blades move quicker, but you get 156 bonus EXP. I don't remember seeing any saw blades on this floor, so I'm kind of okay with that. As far as I know, this floor is mostly just crocodiles, porcupines, and high tax rates. They're like, hey, have you seen that? It's expensive as heck. Permanent heart. Don't mind if I do. We did obtain a permanent heart. But it did not heal us, I believe. What? I was looking up at the top left. I didn't look where I was standing. That's embarrassing. You gotta look where you're walking. Enemies drop more. Spawn an awesome weapon. It's a boomerang. I kinda don't want it. Because what happens when you run out of ammo? You can only have two weapons, and I haven't seen any ammo drops. Get 10 bombs. No. That's a bad trade, because we would only be able to hold two. So. Overall, tough cookies for me on that floor. It spawned a weapon that I didn't really like. Then again, I never used it, because I stuck with the same weapon. I don't know. I have, like, that too-good-use syndrome. If every weapon had ammo, like even the base weapon, then I'd be more willing to use it. But I also just haven't been able to find a way to recover ammo. That's kind of why I don't use the weapons. Not to say the weapons are bad. I mean, like, look at this. These are birds of mass destruction. I mean, that was insane. I've never felt so strong in my life. Mostly because I was homeschooled, so I didn't ever have a chance to feel strong. I'll give you cash, but you can't roll. I'm gonna say no to that, buddy. I have no use for cash. Maybe if you give me bombs, I'd talk about it. But even then, don't know how I feel. Yeah, the air grows colder, buddy. Press Q to switch to the gun while we were in that animation, but I couldn't scroll wheel to switch to the gun. A little interesting decision. Trapped? That doesn't bother me. This gun's insane. You think I'm bothered by being trapped? Oh, you're the last enemy. Okay. Good thing I had that sudden epiphany. Oh, wait, this is the boss fight, you dummy. Crit. What are you talking about? I was rolling like crazy. Dude, I'm so bad at this boss fight. So those, like, pulses didn't actually damage me. At least I would learn something. What time is it? 26 minutes into the run. I'll give it another try. These runs are small, like they're bite-sized, but it's a lot of fun. It's really addicting. It's just easy to press play again. I think that's a good thing from a game. When it's fast, it's easy to get into and out of the game. So you can kind of just like start a run and forget that, you know, you just even played a run. I know I talked about that earlier, but that's one of the primary reasons why Super Meat Boy is still like one of my favorite games, is just the sheer amount of speed you endure in that game. And by speed, what I mean is like you die, it just restarts immediately. I'm actually willing to do this. I think the first floor, that's not too bad. So what do we want to do? But to finish that train of thought, basically when you would play Super Meat Boy, you would immediately, permanent attack speed's pretty insane too. You would immediately restart the room when you died. So it was easy to just keep playing and be like, I'm gonna stop in 30 minutes. And then you realize you said that 3 hours ago. Spiders shoot more bullets, but plus 155 EXP. I'm gonna have to do that. Spiders I don't think will show up until next floor. So that's not actually a bad trade. So right now, it's not going to hinder me to hopefully give me a bonus before that time. We could be using those turtles to help blow up walls, though. I did just realize that in my head. Also, I like the timer on the boxes that tells you how close you are to getting the bombs. That's pretty cool. I was looking over at my OBS to make sure it wasn't too laggy. Unlevel up, get fruit, destroy all stamina, restore all stamina after destroying a box. Honestly, I'll take the on-level up, get fruits. I'm a little, like, scared for my life-ish. Restore wealth. Health. 15% attack speed. 15% crit chance. That's a tough one. I think we'll do the crit chance because we have the permanent attack speed. And then we might as well just buy. I might as well. I'm not too worried about the prices increasing because I haven't even been able to find two shops in a single run, so I should just take it at face value right now, and we should find ways of improving our chances to actually get past that boss fight instead of letting it shackle me and being like, I'll save my money for the next floor, because if I never get a chance to spend it, the spooky ghost is coming and stuff. Alright, well, maybe the spooky ghost shouldn't take away my ability to fight enemies. You should just give that sound effect and not show the animation. Alright, slide headfirst into your demise, bear. You get an A for effort, sir. But nothing higher. Sounds pretty good. I got pretty high there on my multiplier, but I don't think the multiplier is going to reset by the time the boss spawns. And I was right, but... What is happening? I guess since I leveled up, all the bullets were destroyed or something like that. It was weird. Combo's up to 5 now, so we're almost there. Yeah, yeah, this is our moment. Tonight is the night that we get our hands up. Like the dragons can't hold us. Like the dragons can't hold us. Here we go back. Tonight is the moment. Permanent attack speed I should have used earlier. But I was kind of like into that boss fight. We perfected it, which is incredible to me because I'm bad at this game. Honestly, and hear me out here, we don't need the healing. So we're gonna spawn a weapon. Only shoots diagonally on even floors. Shoots horizontally / vertically on odd floors. What? We're gonna take the box that never gets picked. Okay. So we had jalapeno business before. I liked it and I didn't like it. Now, what happened to my level up? Excuse me, sir? It disappeared because of the box that never gets picked. This is why the box never gets picked. This is why the box never gets picked. Excuse me about that ice that you just heard. I have to take constant drinks of water to make sure I'm not losing. Oh god, if you could see the camera right now, I definitely have my eyeballs in my hand trying to rub out the headache that is my inability to play video games when I press F to pick up items in games that clearly F is not used to pick up the items in. So let's just shoot this and see. Alright, it's diagonal on this floor. Not a huge fan of the diagonals, but it could have its uses. Right now, though, let's just stick with this, because I think both weapons are going to do essentially the same thing. One just shoots at an angle. That's not much of a difference. So spiders do shoot more bullets. That was my own decision. I knew it was coming, so this floor is going to be a little bit tougher. We're looking at, you know, more bullets per spider. But I honestly just don't think the spider bullets will be that big a deal. What I think will be a big deal is my inability to aim at the spiders. But it didn't matter that much. So that was pretty good. No level up here. Adds poison damage to your current weapon type. Restore HP after acquiring 10 bombs. Interesting. That'll increase price by 15 to get that bomb, but it's like giving me 2 bombs. 5 more chests to break, and then we should get some bombs. So, what happens... No. Not what I wanted to do. I was gonna say, what happens if I add poison weapon to a... Or poison damage to a weapon that already had poison damage? I wanted to make sure I had that same item, and maybe it was a different item. So I don't know if that was a horrible decision. It probably was. But maybe the poison damage stacks. Let's look on the bright side. Always look on the bright side of poison. Doo-doo. Alright, so let's try to get a combo going here that'll allow us to, upgrade our weapon attack speed permanently again, if we so choose to. Nice you. Nice. Cool. That's what this meter reminds me of. I walked right into that, dude. I would have had weapon attack speed. I had it. I need to increase my peripheral vision skills once again. I used to brag about it. So let's think about this logically. All right. Plus damage to bosses. We're probably gonna fight one boss because I suck at the boss fight and I will most likely die to it. But I'm feeling confident this run. So if we can fight 2 bosses, that's pretty good. But 1000% EXP bonus reduce all choices to 1. This essentially means you level up way faster, but you only get 1 choice. I'm gonna give that a try. Now, it sounds stupid, but we still have a lot of floors before our boss fight. So if we can get to our boss fight with a bunch more levels, maybe like we could even get the boss damage perk. Think about it like that, right? Think positively. Right click him. That was good, I guess, right? I mean, it's not going bad, but I'm out of stamina now. Okay, we're at the Wowie situation. Sick. Wowie. Oh, we lost the combo breaker. But permanent weapon attack speed is pogging off. Alright, so now that I'm incorporating the melee, the spiders haven't been as much of a problem, but we'd still prefer to take them out with our gun, just because I'm a gunslinger. This world ain't big enough for the both of us. Something about a cowboy screaming in the background. So, intriguingly enough, if we do it like this, dude, that was big brain. That was big brain. You gotta admit, that was a little bit smart. I was able to use the bomb to accurately destroy the left. I mean, it wasn't like hard to do. I don't wanna like give myself too much credit, but it was just smart to do, right? This game might be a little loud in OBS. I'm noticing that it's peaking a little bit high, so I'm gonna reduce the volume a little bit on the OBS sliders. So I apologize if it gets a little bit quieter. Breaking a box spawns quills. Now, this is a rare skip. This is a rare skip from me. You won't see this too often. So let's try to keep up the aggression here and get our combo meter rolling. Because if we can keep up the aggression and keep the combo meter rolling, then we'll get closer to attack speed. I know I'm sounding like a broken record at this point, but it's not broken. It's just that the record repeats itself pretty often, alright? Dude, you need some pills for that. You got a lot of nausea going on there. Alright, so that level up. Current weapon type shoots two bullets, dealing 65% damage. Alright. This is a tough one. As I've stated before, I don't understand ammo. But this sounds hilarious. For like this diagonal gun? Two bullets per shot. I don't know though. Dude, okay. I feel like people would be upset if I didn't take this with a diagonal gun. Okay, so it's not, I expected it to be like a spread. It's not what I expected it to be. But it'll still be good, for sure. In the end, I would like to use the diagonal gun, but it just might not work out like that. I just need to figure out how the ammo works in this game. So I guess that's on me for not even using the weapons or giving them a chance. We'll try to give it a chance here, because it's going to be sideways, so it'll be a little bit better to shoot this gun, so we'll give it a try. I mean, the damage of it is no joke. It's definitely strong. Okay, yeah, I'm realizing this gun is insanely strong. All right, I didn't give this weapon nearly enough credit. This gun is my friend. Deflecting, that's not good because I'm bad. It's as simple as that. If I was good, it would be good. If I'm bad, it's not good. Because I don't think about deflecting bullets on a daily basis. Not saying I shouldn't, I'm saying I don't. Does he take my golden heart? He does. He also gave me 4 bombs, which was over my bomb capacity. So watch this. One bomb will get us in here, which gave us a bomb back. So what's the play? Is there like any way we can get to a bunch of stuff linked together? Let's look around a bit. We're not on any timer, so I could play this a little bit slower, but thankfully the floors aren't huge, so there's not like a ton of exploring to do. Like in Noida, when you decide to explore the rest of the floor, it's just like massive. No. So I'm gonna save my bombs, was my decision there. Now, for the diagonals here, I think it can still be good. I don't want to put the gun down at all, because the gun itself is insanely good. Like, look at that. What was that? What was that red bar? But now we're going to have to start our boss fight, so the real question is, what gun do I want to use on this? We'll try this gun for now. Okay, so we did get the dodge there, even though I had to use all of my stamina. Okay, it's in between the first and the second one. First and the second one. There it is! Wait, he shot twice! First and the second, and he shoots twice! Holy moly. I've escaped? Alright, so we're running out of ammo. That took like a lot of my ammo. Meep-meep-meep. To you too, sir. I gotta use two bombs to get in there. It's gotta be worth it, right? I mean, we're at the point where I think we have to. Kind of have to. No bad choice, this is a freebie. Well, I don't have any permanent bonuses from drinking those, so unfortunately, that freebie isn't gonna matter too much. We could have done these chests, but it's too late now, so give it a go. Take me to church. Ah. Okay, what do you got first? You're doing your bullets. And I immediately took damage, but it did get rid of the second tier of bullets. Okay, that weapon also has range, and then I walked right into it. Oh, dude, I'm so upset. I hate that attack. I think I'm overestimating that attack, though. I really feel like I am. I just need to figure out what I'm doing wrong. I'm trying to run from the bullets and then dodge the second one, but it's biting me. It's biting me bad. All right, so thanks so much for watching this one. Leave a like if you liked the video. Comment down below if you got anything you want to say about the game. I'm having a good time. Even though I'm not beating this boss, I'm having a good time. I'll see you guys in the next one.